So I'm joined by just Jack, or Jack Allsopp, as you're known.
Yeah.
This must be the first time you've been to Luxembourg. Have you had a look around? How's it been?
I have had a little look around. It's very autumnal out there. The trees are looking very golden and kind of nice. Kind of quite fairy tale-y, isn't it? It's quite sort of Disney, that middle bit of the thing. You can imagine weird little cartoon deer running through it or something like that. So
a little visit from Bambi.
Exactly.
This is your last date in Europe, isn't it?
Yes.
So you're heading back to the UK. How's Europe been for you?
Europe's been amazing. Absolutely, totally exceeded all our expectations. Every show's been brilliant. Now why do you want to go and put stars in their eyes? Why do you want to go and put stars in their eyes? So why do you want to go and put stars in their eyes? Now why do you want to go and put stars in their eyes?
It's Halloween today.
Yeah.
So
we saw a geezer rollerblading with like a werewolf's mask on, getting chased by kids on bikes. I don't know what that's about. It looked like Teen Wolf or something. But
so, what do you think of Halloween? This begs the question: is it all fun and games, or is it kind of just one of them more corporate events to get the sweets and beers sold?
I mean, like Halloween, I always think of it as like an American thing. Do you know what I mean? More than like anything else. So we used to go trick or treating and that kind of thing, but we knew there was a place where loads of like expat Americans lived in Primrose Hill, and we used to go around there because they'd have like loads of sweets and stuff basically. So
fantastic for Goth of the Disco tonight, surely.
Yes. Oh yeah, exactly. Yeah, definitely. She hates all the music, can't stand the lights, but there's nothing else to do on a Saturday night, and she doesn't like the people, can't stand to dance, so they're all going home in an ambulance.
So 3 albums in now. After the huge success of Overtones, did you feel a bit of pressure going into the third album?
No, because I never put pressure on myself to like sell records. Like I didn't expect Overtones. I never expected to be in a position where I was considered like a pop person at all. I never like aimed for that.
Yeah.
So not at all, really. I mean, I think that any kind of success in the music industry is to be kind of, you've got to be thankful for it, because there's so many people making music and making no money and having no success at all. So I always look at it in that kind of way, with a slightly philosophical view that anything above nothing is good. Do you count the flakes when it snows? And can you feel the heat or only the afterglows? Do you count the flakes when it snows? Yeah.
So there was the Outer Marker, 2002. Which was kind of an angst-ridden, a bit more personal.
Yeah, much more personal. Mm-hmm. All about the relationships I'd had and was having, and yeah, it's a lot more personal. I think I've kind of that was enough for me of like the sort of stuff about me and how I felt about things. And I think the second album is probably a little bit of a mixture of the two, and then the third album is much more about other people and characters that I've either made up or I've met, and kind of their stories. Once you start doing this for a job, your life kind of changes a lot. You know, before you start doing this, you can write about all the jobs and you've had. Like in my first album, there was like stuff about, you know, all the people I'd met when I was working and all that kind of thing. And once you start doing this, like all you can, you're not going to write about tour busing. I mean, people obviously do write about fame and that kind of thing, which obviously most people find incredibly boring. But yeah, I think it was time to just think about, you know, other people's stories. Checking out the young bucks, celebrating as they circle around the snake.
As I was saying, that it's kind of moved on to a kind of social commentary, really, with yourself. But that's kind of been easier to follow than your music, the obviously backing tracks and someone like that. They've kind of been a bit more schizophrenic within albums, drifting from different kind of genres, because you kind of get a bit of groove, funk, disco, even some jazz orientation.
I just get a little bit bored in the studio sometimes doing the same kind of thing. I'm always hearing stuff that I kind of want to try and incorporate in my own music, and so I just mess around, really. Do you know what I mean? And like sometimes it works and sometimes it sounds rubbish, but obviously no one gets to hear the rubbish bits, but I hope they don't anyway.
The new album, All Night Cinema, it's kind of got a bit more of a darker kind of album, you think, than Overtones?
Yeah, it is a little bit.
Do you feel it's kind of got a, the world has got a bit darker since Overtones?
I'm not really sure. I think the world's always a little bit like it's a little bit messed up, isn't it? I mean, I think it always has been. I think that it's more to do with like my outlook on it. Yeah, I mean, I think, you know, it's kind of looking at those darker things without being kind of too depressed about them. Do you know what I mean? I think that's the kind of, you know, I don't want to make like dirgy kind of music. Do you know what I mean? Sure. But at the same time, yeah, I wanted to like reflect things that, you know, I do have a bit more of a dark outlook than people would think. You know, I mean, people who know me would say I'm a bit of a doom and gloom sort of merchant. Do you know what I mean? But at the same time, I guess like I'm quite hopeful about things. Do you know what I mean? I have a certain amount of faith in the human spirit, even though there's not a lot sometimes to back that up. But there you go.
And the track Embers is kind of a really different track, I thought, from you. Really kind of ear-catching, like the string blasts to start off. Was there any debate about whether that would be the opening track of the album?
No, not at all. I mean, I think when I played it to the record label, I didn't think anyone would really get it. And when I played it to the record label, they like immediately said that it would be the first single and that it should probably open the album. We couldn't think of I don't think there was a better track to open the album. It started off with like a loop that I had, and I just had this idea of doing like a repeated kind of line thing, and I started doing the claps and stuff. And then the vocals, I was a little bit drunk with my mates in the studio one day, and I'd been watching like a really dark like war film, and I just started to write some lines, and then I went downstairs and they were just sitting there and we were a bit pissed, and like I just sung them, and they were like, it sounds a bit rubbish. You sound like a choir boy or something like that. And then when I played it back with everything overlaid over the top of itself, it sounded really good. And then they were like, oh, right, then, okay, you're not such an idiot. The facts and the figures, they overwhelm and stifle everything.